one, let me show the UI load, and you can, this is my slide from the computer. Because there's a trust picture, the world is too small, I think it's not good to use a projector to show to you. So if you have a laptop or other device, then you can access this UI load. Let me give you guys 30 seconds. Okay. And after you access this URL, if you don't like the content, then you can go to other session. It is still allowed. I'm okay. in this time, maybe I introduce myself. I'm Joey Lee from the SUSE Taipei office. I'm now working in the SUSE labs and with the Heavy Lean and the Max Lean. And my responsibility is for contribute to the SUSE kernel and also the upstream kernel for the ACPI, UDFI, and now sometimes contribute to the hearing or the now the editing, those fields. And so I choose this topic to introduce you guys about how to contribute to the open source kernel. Actually, not just open source, the same thing maybe also you can apply to the mainline kernel. Okay, then let's go ahead. How to contribute to the open source kernel? This is the agenda, I think just a okay, this is the Linux kernel, and we can see the it's just an A, like an A. The this kernel has some functionality, and it's called basically is POSIX compatible. So application can use a POSIX compatible API to access those services that provided by Linux kernel. And on the other hand, Linux also provided some Linux specific functions to the user space. So the application also can using those API to access the service that provided by the Linux kernel. So it's basically this picture is this concept. Okay. So the open source kernel is a central component of the Linux operating system. I believe that just open source distro, the other distros like this. And the kernel is measured power resource like the CPU, memory, and hard drive, and provide the abstraction and provide application with a consistent view of those resources. So you can use standard API to access those resources to implement your application on user space. Okay, then if you want to look at the kernel of an open source, then there have two repositories you can access by the Git. The first one is the kernel source.git. This Git tree is the main Git tree of the open source kernel. After you come in, and every development process all on this Git tree. I will introduce later. So another one is the kernel.git. This one is for you if what you want to just look at or want to change the source code, but you will not contribute to the open source kernel, then you can use this tree because the file structure is similar to the Linux tree. Okay, then I want to introduce one tool, the name is Quark. We use this tool to maintain the, our kernel page or to the open source kernel. So this, I will not too deep detail to introduce this tool. You can search it from the internet, but it's very useful for you to maintain those page. Here is some usually we have some quiet command to help us. Like the first one is you can use a quiet to import one new page, or you one page, zp page, and maybe you can use a quiet new to create a new page color under the source code. Then you can use a quiet push to push those page, and then you can use a quiet pop to pop to the last page. The quiet pop can tell you now which page is covered on the top of the source code. And quiet edit, you can start to edit the source code apply to the current top page. And finally, the quiet refresh. After you edit the source code, then you can refresh the current top page. Okay, then how to use the kernel source repository? This is the main repository for maintaining and developing the OpenSUSE kernel. The first, of course, you need to use a Git clone to clone this Git repository. Then go to move to the kernel source folder. Then run this script and install Git hook. This hook will set up the environment for your development. Okay, here we have one layout, a simple layout of the kernel source Git repository. There have some different architecture, different flavor. Those are config files put to the config folder. And the second, there are some page. It's a different group for the different reason for why we put those page on our kernel source. Basically, we will choose one mainline kernel. Then we put our page, SUSE page, OpenSUSE page, and maybe some backpoint page to fix some bug. Use a quiet to apply those page to our OpenSUSE kernel. Then RPM folder is a special folder to help you to build out the kernel RPM by local, or you can push to the OpenSUSE build services to build out your kernel RPM. This afternoon, we have one session hosted by our colleague Jeffrey Zhang. He will introduce this part. And the KAPI is some reference file about the kernel KAPI. And the script, some scripts help you to develop the loaded page. Okay, then kernel source, open source kernel source, we will, each version, we develop the each open source, then we will choose a one kernel version. Like 13.2 is this 80.7 is kernel version, and like 42.1 is user 4.1.xy is a kernel version like this. So basically, our kernel source is from the Linux. So Linux, the Linux from those B3, the mainline kernel version can apply the some backporting page and also apply the some state open source specific page or source specific page on those on the kernel source and use all the kernel. Okay. Then for the kernel source repository, how use the first thing always to read the README file, then almost some important information in this file you should read it first. Then we will apply, there will be one special file is a 0.com file, which can apply to the first page by order. And I will introduce later. And here we have some metadata. And I will skip this slide because we will go more detail. And the flavor. There are some different flavor of the open source kernel. The main three flavors you can overwhelming by the people. So when you install the, after you install the OpenSUSE lib or the OpenSUSE maybe Tumbleweed or something, the kernel is built by the default computer. So if you got a problem, want to check the configuration, then you should check the default file first. Then, if you want a more detailed debug, maybe enable some debug options to build the OpenSUSE kernel, then you should apply use a debug computer to review your kernel and check your problem. Then another one is the vanilla kernel. Vanilla kernel means the upstream kernel. We do not do any change of those configuration. Then you, if you want to compare with the midnight kernel and the OpenSUSE kernel, the difference to find out what happened, then you may need to use the vanilla configuration to build your kernel and compare the difference. Another tool is the EC2 and Zen. Is also for different platform, either for EC2 and for the Zen platform to build our kernel. Okay, different flavors. Here we have one started making the, I'm sorry for the word maybe small, but I think you can reference my slide. I just give you guys the URL. The structure like this in the config folder, here we have some different architecture like SAT64 and ARM64, like S390. You can check these those architecture, and then in those architecture folder they have some different flavor like Vanilla or maybe EC2. Okay, the other JavaScript can help you to develop the OpenSUSE kernel page. The first one is a very important one. Almost is the second maybe. The first script you should run, the name is sequence page. Either way, this script will use a card to apply the whole page to the kernel source. Then you can start to use a query to control the those page. And second one is the refresh page. Because we need to maintain some metadata or some metadata in the page, so use this script to replace the quite refresh. So after you edit the one page, edit one file and want to refresh the page, then you should use this part script. The latest one is log. It's also important script for you. You want to commit new page on the list page. And after that, you can push it on the view server or to push it to git. Then you need to use this. You can use this log. Then it will help you to write down the your log. Okay. About the world is just all. But here have one page headers and introduce you. There have some super specific top page. We will need to follow up. The first one is the key commit. Is it better? Okay, the first one is the key commit. It's from the kernel option. Maybe sometimes you backport a page from the new kernel to the OpenSUSE kernel. Then you need to write down the option key commit. Address here, and the second the page landline maybe your backporting page, backport page is from the 4.7 RT1 version from the kernel option. Then you should write down here, and the third one is the reference. Reference is also important to point this page to one page. Page means the functions of the OpenSUSE or SUSE. And maybe a pointer to the one bar. It's important because we can check why we need to apply this page. Please understand that we will not apply a page we don't know why. We should have a reason to apply the page. Maybe even any sentence, we need to know why we need to apply it to the kernel source. So that's why need these references or this field to write down why we need this page. And here, please add your after you paper page, you will found there is a sign of or the view by sign of by the from the connection. And the policy is if you want to contribute to the open source kernel, then you should put your own email here to apply the you need to use the etc by here to apply your etc by tag here to make sure who suggests to apply this tag or who finally who applies this tag. Another case, sometimes the page does not accept the kernel option, maybe it's just it's under reviewing or finally the kernel option don't like it because maybe some reason, but we still need the function. So in this situation, maybe we still allow to apply this page, but the open source kernel team need to accept it. So it's an exception, but if we accept it, then we should write down the where is this page from? Or sometimes like this is from the master query, the lead, because it's a page that's not allowed by the Linux formula, but we still need it. So we took this page from this lead, then write down this queue in a subsystem maintainer repository, and write down the GitHub of this URL, and of course we need to commit and records. And please remember, always add a new extra file. Okay, I start to want to skip some slides because here I don't have enough time to finish it, but I think you can look at So, those tags are important for, I just introduce you guys for why we need those tags. Those are hashtags to look up it, to indicate why we need this page, or where this page from, or was it like, who, that who made it, you, who suggests to apply this page, or who applied this page. And reference is maybe some case thing. You will see PSC number or PSC number, PO number, those numbers are from the Mozilla. We apply case have two reasons. One is for new function, another one is for bug fixing. So either new function or bug fixing, we all have a number to check. Why do we need to apply the function or why do we need to apply apply the cache to this bug. So PSD is bazila.com and PSD is bazila.com. PO is bazila open source tau. And the beta is for the you can access the open source beta. If you have one beta website, you can create your own beta that the open source team or open source kernel team will review your thing and make sure it's we want this to start function in the next open source version. After it passed, then you can start to development it, or someone will start to development it and apply those page to the open source kernel or open source. Okay, then, so if we fix the bug, normally a bug, we always have a lot of bug need to take care of. So if you have time, if you're interested, you can search or open source Mozilla and have some bug. You can choose the one interesting field you want to involve. Then you can start to help to test those things. Okay, for serverless account, after, because we have many different reasons to apply those pages, but those pages need to have an order. And then so we have one file that name is serverless account in the folder of the kernel source, and you can store a lot of pages and apply there. And the sequence, this sequence page will reference this order to apply those pages to the kernel source. Slide is you can store different group, have a different page, have many different group, and those page about the users group, and then you can see that sometimes they have a fake number, or sometimes they have some reason for why don't apply those page. Another case, so you can see the we will put the Bandida number here, or fake number here, or even the CV means security issue, so we will apply those page for to fix the CV problem. So we'll have those number in the CV.com. Then anyone can chase it to make sure why we need those page and what happened, and finally found who applied this page. Here is a simple command to use for your reference to view the OpenSUSE kernel in your computer. On your computer, it's a very simple, after you declare the kernel source, then use a sequence page to apply to those pages. Sequence page will generate one tab folder and put the image folder for OpenSUSE 42.2, those kind of folder in the temp folder. Then you go to this, you can go to this folder and copy one flavor, one architecture and flavor configured to the folder. Then after here is a demo. The example is you want to view the SAP64 architecture, the default config flavor. Then you just copy the default file to the kernel source. Then you name it to the dark config. Then you submit. Yeah, everything done. Okay, then after that, you can choose if you have maybe development, after you development one kernel page, then you want to check the mode. Maybe this page will affect to the other feature, or can you view on the users, and you can use this load script to push the kernel source to open source users. And it will start to build a kernel source. Okay, well, I will not go detail to this thing because this afternoon has a session to discuss this. Okay, the submit your page. After you development the page, maybe for the publishing or for one new function, of course you need submit to the submit your page to the option, maybe open to the kernel or even the Linux kernel. Then the expert or other guys will review your page and make sure there is no problem in your page. Then after that, if they have two other people sign off your page, maybe by the sign off by paper, or the review by paper is also, maybe tested by is also, and it's also allowed. More than two people sign off your page, then this page will be accepted by the kernel community. Even on the Linux kernel community is also allowed. I have a question. Okay. So, I see. Okay, then the point, the most important, of course, you need to subscribe the OpenSUSE kernel, OpenSUSE.org, this mailing address, then you can start the mailing list. Or you just want to check the old mail. In the you can access this mailing list archive. Q&A. Okay.
Any question?
So we did your time.
Can OpenSUSE run in a microkernel for supporting IoT release?
So for supporting what release?
IoT.
Okay. IoT. Cool.
The question is, can this kernel now support the IoT device or IoT maybe the development for like this? And currently, we support this Raspberry Pi by the ARM in the ARM flavor. And for the other IoT development for the company, I'm not sure anyone. Satana, do you know anyone support the OpenSUSE kernel?
OpenSUSE in microkernel to support IoT devices.
Yeah. Banana Pi is also. Okay.
Oh, banana.
Yeah, that's right. Thanks for Sakana's help.
So it's
possible. Yeah. So it's about it's about berry pie or banana pie. So, but for the maybe lower power, even for like Arduino or some other border, we are not supporting that. Yeah. So that's my answer.
Bisa ya mas, bisa support. Satu lagi pertanyaan.
But if you are interested, maybe you can give them a you can follow one project. Because of the ARM support, actually the very originally ARM support of the OpenSUSE kernel is also founded by OpenSUSE community. It's now developed by the SUSE company. So if you are interested in porting the OpenSUSE kernel to other development ports and welcome, you can just found the one project.
Bisa gabung di komunitinya mas ya. Oke. Okay. No question? No more question? Oke.
Okay. Thank you for your time. I am Toto from PTKP DIY, Balai Teknologi Komunikasi Pendidikan, the House of Education and Communication Technology in Yogyakarta Province. As my head has she has already talked to us that we in this province provide the OpenSUSE for more than 10,000 PCs computers in Yogyakarta province. Until now we still use 12.4 versions of OpenSUSE Live Linux for education.
Okay.
My question is there any update for the OpenSUSE Live version and how we can get this update? Thank you. OpenSUSE Live, Linux for education. Do you know about that?
So your question is
so how to upgrade the kernel or something yes. with the live, right?
Yeah.
Live version, you want to upgrade the kernel.
We still use the 12.4 version.
We still use 12.4 version of Linux OpenSUSE.
Yeah.
And we want to upgrade the system because we want to get more for OpenSUSE, yeah.
Okay, thank you. So, thanks. Maybe I can answer the question. So, is there another member for the live project? His name is Lars. So, maybe when you come back, we will contact the project leader to for your project. I think they might be published soon, yeah, because the live have some project life cycle. But it's not normal like the OpenSUSE or other edition like the Chang State. Yeah. But we will bring this question to last the member.
Because it is very interesting for us. And now in our province, 10,000. More than 10,000 PCs use OpenSUSE, and maybe that is the most
okay.
the most uses of OpenSUSE in province in Indonesia, maybe.
Yeah.
So we want to continue this usage, and maybe with the news update from OpenSUSE, many teachers will still want to use OpenSUSE more and more.
Oh, sure. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you